In this video, we're finishing out the worksheet Area of Triangles and Quadrilaterals on the KutaSoftware website under the Geometry section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 11. In number 11, you can see that we have a trapezoid, and the area of a trapezoid is 1/2 the sum of the bases times the height. So if you're confused on that formula, go back to the previous video where we wrote the formula out and did a few simple practice problems. However, now we have to also worry about the conversion of our units. We have one base in inches, another base in inches, and then we have feet. So we either need to convert to inches or convert to feet. Let's convert to feet. And in order to convert to feet, we're going to take 33.6 inches and we're going to multiply it by 1 over 12, since in 1 foot, there's 12 inches. So my inches will cancel out. So 33.6 divided by 12 equals 2.8. So this is 2.8 feet for one of the bases. My other base, I'll divide that by 12 inches and also multiply it by 1 foot. So multiplying by 1 doesn't change the number of inches. However, when we divide by 12, we'll get that 16.8 divided by 12 equals 1.4 feet. So now let's plug those numbers into our area formula. Area equals 1/2 the sum of the bases, so 2.8 feet plus 1.4 feet times the height of 1 foot. So area is going to equal 1/2 times 2.8 feet plus 1.4 feet, which equals 4.2 feet. And that is also multiplied by 1 foot, the height. So area equals 1/2 times 4.2 feet times 1 foot. And that will equal 2.1 feet squared. So in number 11, the area of our trapezoid is 2.1 feet squared. In number 12, we have a parallelogram and both of our units are the same. For parallelogram, area equals base times height. So the area is going to equal 6 kilometers times 4.7 kilometers. 6 times 4.7 equals 28.2, and that's 28.2 kilometers squared for number 12. In number 13, our units are feet and inches, so let's convert inches to feet. We'll do that by dividing by 12, or multiplying by 1/12, and that's 1 foot over 12 inches. So 1 foot over 12 inches, the inches will cancel out, so that'll leave me with 16.8 divided by 12, which equals 1.4 feet. So area equals 1.4 feet times 1.4 feet, which is 1.96 feet squared. In number 14, all our units are the same. That's meters. This is a trapezoid, since we have two sides that are parallel. For a trapezoid, the area equals 1/2 the sum of the bases times the height. So in this case, area equals 1/2 the sum of the bases, which is 2.3 meters plus 7.9 meters times the height, which is 4.6 meters. So you can see in number 14, we're given extraneous information. 4.9 meters is not the height, it is the length of one of the sides. But we need the height, which is 4.6. So area equals 1/2, 2.3 plus 7.9 equals 10.2 meters. And we're multiplying that by 4.6 meters. So area equals 1/2 times 10.2 times 4.6, which will give us 23.46. And that's meters squared. In number 15, we have a triangle. The area of a triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. So that's 1/2 our base, which is 10 kilometers, since we're looking at the height that's perpendicular to that base. So our base is 10 kilometers, and our height is 5.6 kilometers. So area equals 1/2 times 10 times 5.6, which is 28, and that's kilometers squared. In number 16, we have a parallelogram. However, before we plug the base and height into the formula, we need to convert. We're going to convert inches to feet. So we're going to multiply by 1/12, 1 foot over 12 inches, or simply divide by 12 inches. So 91.2 divided by 12 equals 7.6. So our base is 7.6 feet. So area equals base, which is 7.6 feet, times the height, which is 7 feet. Area equals 7.6 times 7, which is 53.2 feet squared. In number 17, we have another trapezoid. And lucky for us, all the measurements are in the same unit. So area equals 1/2, the sum of the bases, 3.2 centimeters plus 9 centimeters multiplied by the height of 6 centimeters. So area equals 1/2 times 3.2 plus 9 is 12.2 centimeters. And that will get multiplied to 6 centimeters. So area equals 1/2 times 12.2 times 6, which equals 36.6. And that's 36.6 centimeters squared. In number 18, we have a triangle, and we have that the base is 9 centimeters, and the height, which is perpendicular to the base, is 76 millimeters. So we're going to convert millimeters to centimeters. And there's 10 millimeters in a centimeter. So we'll take 76 millimeters and divide it by 10, or simply multiply by 1 centimeter over 10 millimeters. You can see that the millimeters will cancel out, and we'll get 7.6 centimeters. So now for our area. Area equals 1/2 the base times the height. So that's 1/2 of 9 centimeters times 7.6 centimeters. So area equals 1/2 times 9 times 7.6, which is 34.2, and that's centimeters squared. In number 19, we're given all the same units. They give us three sides, however, we only need the base and the height, and since this is a square, those are all equivalent. So area is going to equal 5.1 miles times another 5.1 miles. So area equals 5.1 times 5.1, which equals 26.01 miles squared. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 20. For a trapezoid, area equals 1/2 the sum of the bases times the height. Everything is in the same units, so one base is 8.4 yards, and the other base is 4.2 yards. And that gets multiplied to the height, which is perpendicular to the bases, so 3.6 yards. And again, they give us extraneous information, so we can ignore the fact that this side is 4.4 yards. So area equals 1/2, 8.4 plus 4.2 is 12.6, so that's 12.6 yards times 3.6 yards. So area equals 1/2 times 12.6 times 3.6, which equals 22.68, and that's going to be yards squared. So 22.68 yards squared is the answer in number 20. Now before I move on to the critical thinking questions, if you haven't already, subscribe to this channel. Now hopefully that you've done that, let's move on to number 21. It says sketch and label a trapezoid that has an area of 100 centimeters squared. We know that a trapezoid has a pair of opposite sides or parallel, and the area of a trapezoid is 1/2 the sum of the bases, so base 1, plus another base, call it base 2, times the height. So if we want 100 centimeters squared, we'll draw something that equals 100. So base 1 plus base 2 times 1/2 times the height equals 100. So going even further with this formula, if we were to multiply both sides by 2, we would cancel out the 1/2. So 200 needs to equal the sum of the bases times the height. So what two numbers equal 200? So we just need to pick two numbers. When multiplied together, they equal 200. So let's use 20 and 10. So the sum of the bases will equal 20 and the height will equal 10. So we can plug in that the height is 10 centimeters. And now we need to pick two separate numbers for the bases. If they add up to 20, let's make one base 8 centimeters and the other base can be 12 centimeters. Now let's double check. Area equals 1/2 the bases, so 8 centimeters plus 12 centimeters times the height of 10 centimeters. We know that area equals 1/2, 8 centimeters plus 12 centimeters is 20 centimeters, and that's multiplied to 10 centimeters. And we know that indeed 1/2 times 20 times 10 equals 100. So we do get that the area is 100 centimeters squared. So one base is 8 centimeters, another base is 12 centimeters, and the height is 10 centimeters. In number 22, it says to change one number in the diagram that we just drew for the last question so that the area is 200 centimeters squared. So currently for our area, we have the 100 centimeters squared is equal to 1/2 of the sum of our bases, which is 8 centimeters plus 12 centimeters times our height of 10 centimeters. And it's asking us to change one number so that the area is now 200 centimeters. So if the area is 200 centimeters now, we need to multiply both sides by 2. So 2 times 100 centimeters squared will be 200 centimeters squared. So essentially, we have to multiply one number on our right by 2. So let's multiply the height. So now, as opposed to the height equaling 10 centimeters, the height is now going to equal 20 centimeters. So all we have to do is double the height. Since we doubled the area, we just need to double the height. And that will give us 200 centimeters squared. And with that, we finish out this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. And they also let you know when I come out with new videos. So go ahead and subscribe now.